Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here with a new art journal layout. As we are self-isolated at home, I like to play a lot on my journals lately, and since I'm working on different projects, I like to turn on the camera and film it for you as well. So I'm sharing today an art journal that I made using products from the new Dilusions range, the new collection, and I will be working on my Dilusions art journal today. For the background, I will be working with two paints from the new collections by Dilusions, the green and the blue one. Now the blue is called Blue Hawaiian and the green one is called Sour Appletini. They are both very bright colors, almost neon I would say, but since I'm going to apply them with a baby wipe, it does dilute the color and it goes really pale. But of course you can build up the color or you can apply it with a brush, which is going to keep it nice and bright. I'm planning to do some collage at the top using collage papers by Dilusions, which are very busy and very bright with lots of designs on top. So I want to keep the background quite subtle. That's why I decided to go with a baby wipe at the background and keep it quite pale. And notice that I'm not doing a perfect application, nothing is blended beautifully. That doesn't really matter, you will see everything will come together at the end. I'm going to do some stenciling now. I'm using a new stencil by Darkroom Door. I absolutely love the design. I think that numbers or letters are perfect for backgrounds. And this one is called Alphabet Jumble. Just like always, you will find everything that I'm using linked down below. I'm applying again the two same paints that I used for the background, very lightly, keeping the background really subtle. And this time I am applying them with a blending tool instead of a baby wipe. And I zoomed in for you so you can see the design better. The letters are there in the background, but they do stay in the background. They don't turn into a focal point since I didn't use black or any other really vibrant color. Now I'm going to bring in another stencil which is new. This is again by Darkroom Door and it is called Grunge Borders. This one is awesome for creating borders all around and I will be using it later on my project, on this project. But for now I'm using the line with the diamond shapes and I'm applying green paint over them. Adding visual texture, making sure that it's going to add something interesting for the eye at the background, but at the same time keeping everything really subtle. Now, just like always, I will add some white splashes. I'm doing that with a spray that I have, white spray by Altenew, but of course you can dilute gesso or white paint with water and just spray all over the place if you like splashes like I do. Now, in the Dilusions collection, there are two packs of collage papers. It is packed with pages. I think there are 24 pages in each one of those packs. They give you different designs, all arts by Diane, like bodies and legs and heads and different bits and pieces that you can use for backgrounds. I absolutely love them. There are so many different ways to use them and make them your own. You don't have to use them as they are. I'm going quickly through some of them so you can take a look on how it looks and I will try and find what I want to work with today. So finally I picked those legs which I'm going to use my scissors and fuzzy cut them. And of course you can use your scissors and fuzzy cut everything, keep them in a box just like Diane does. You can do that while watching TV, listening to music or on an audiobook. I love fuzzy cutting and it's something that I don't mind doing. And to tell you the truth, I find it very relaxing since I don't have to think anything. I just use my scissors and go all around the lines. Now, I brought here this page that has some houses and I'm going to cut out a few of them. And trust me, I had no plan on how this page would look like from the beginning. I just created a background just like Diane does. And then I went through all those different bits and pieces on her, of her designs on these collage pages and picked a few of them. Try it out, I promise you, it's not difficult. You will have lots of fun while doing all the collage and you will end up with a lovely page. Now, in the packs there are some pages that are great for creating borders, like these ones for example. You can cut them out like this or vertically, which is going to ensure that you will have all the designs on your page. So I'm going to do that, cut out enough so that I can create a border around my page, and then I'm going to start sticking down. For sticking down everything, I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue, but of course you can use matte medium or any other stick glue that you have. Just make sure that you don't use any wet glue that is going to make that paper super wet, soaking wet, and it's going to create wrinkles on it. I'm going to put on some music and let you see how I put my page together, and then I will come back for the little details. Now, I want to create the illusion that she's super, super tall. That's why I added those tiny little houses at the bottom. And I'm also drawing a couple of clouds using one of the patterns from the collage papers. And again, you can see I'm not using it as a heart. I just like the design, and I'm using it as clouds. I'm going to stick them down. And for some of the clouds, I want them to be behind her legs. I think those clouds really add into the whole composition and make her look even bigger. I'm going with three clouds. I like three when it comes to our journaling. So you see I have three houses and three clouds. And now I'm going to bring in my black marker and my white marker. And as I was getting ready to do my doodling, I decided that I wanted to whiten up the clouds just a little bit. So I'm bringing in some gesso, and with a very wet brush, I'm going to add just a touch here and there. This is going to make them look whiter, but at the same time, I'm not covering up the design on the clouds completely. You can still see through them, but I think they pop out even more now. Now I'm going to use my thin black pen, and I'm going all around the cutouts. This is going to help them stand against the background. They are going to pop better on my page, and I'm going to do this detail not only for the houses or for the legs, but also I will go all over and around the border. I will also add black lines around the clouds, everything. Now, on all my layouts, I always have a quote, and this is no exception. So for this one, I'm using a lovely quote that I got from Darkroom Door that says, "Just act normal, that's crazy enough." I'm going to stamp that on the empty space that I have on this page. And for that, I'm using black archival ink. I'm using a stamping block for stamping this just because it is quite big, and I know that I will not have a great impression, the perfect impression, since this is a book and it is quite bulky. However, I can always go back with a black marker and blacken up some of those letters just to help them stand out even more. Now I'm going to bring in my acrylic markers and I'm going to have some fun with them. This collage paper is perfect for writing on top of it, either with your pens or your markers. So I'm going to bring in some colors, like oranges and yellows and blues. And the idea here is to brighten up the colors even more. So you see I'm going with Liquitex marker here, over the roofs. I did add red on the polka dots of her leggings. Now I'm using oranges and yellows on some of the houses. And you can see how I can easily brighten up the colors. These are acrylic markers. I'm using two brands here. I believe these are Liquitex and Pebbio. I will link to some of them down below so you can check them out. They come with different nibs. They go opaque on top of paper. But if you adjust a little bit, you can still keep the designs that they have underneath. The fun part about using acrylic markers is that you can completely customize the collage designs, so you can completely change the color of a house if you go on top of it with another color. So you see how easy it is to make them your own. And if you follow my videos, you already know that I have to finish off a layout with my white gel pen, adding highlights here and there. I'm not paying too much attention on where the light is, I just like to have those white lines all over my cutouts. I think they add something whimsical, they help them stand out even more. And it's a touch that I absolutely love. I will also add some white lines on a couple of walls just to help them stand out even more. I think that the two walls that are more important on my quote are the word normal and crazy. So that's what I'm doing. I'm only adding highlights on the right side of those letters. It is just one of those things that I like to do on pretty much every page that I make. Now again, I'm going to bring in this grungy borders stencil by Darkroom Door, and I will use the line that has those X's all over. I'm going to use some washi tape and cover up the left and right design since I want to use only this one. And I'm going to bring in my paste. This is modeling paste or embossing paste, whatever you have. I'm using a very small spatula. And I'm going to pick up some paste with the back of my spatula. Do not pick up paste with the front. The back is the side that you are, after all, going to spread it out on top of your project. I'm not going to add the stitches all over the border. I'm just picking different areas here and there. And by having the washi tape on the left and on the right of my stencil, I make sure that I don't make a mess picking out more designs from the stencil that I don't want to. And that is the finishing touch for my layout. Here are some close-up photos on the project that I made for today. I hope that you had fun and that you got inspired to play with collage papers. It's lots of fun and very relaxing. Thank you all so much for joining me today. You will find the links to everything I used down below in the description area. I'm sending you all lots of hugs. Stay safe and have a lovely day.